But awesome. We're recording. We're live. I'm excited. Let's go ahead and click on speaker view here. I'd love to see all your beautiful hand, but if not, I understand life's going on. It's a Tuesday night. It stormed all day here, but I feel like really, we've been bringing the heat in QC, and life is abundant. We're at our highest volume ever, approaching 110,000 volume in the company. Teams are growing, ranks are being hit, accounts are being, I want to say blown up, but that sounds bad, but they're blowing up, right? They're going up and up and up and up. And, you know, there's a lot of amazing things that are going on. You know, I've been saying that I feel like I can touch the abundance. You guys ever feel like something's going so well, you can touch the abundance? You can touch the energy. It's tangible, right? That's what I feel like we're at. You know, I've seen some teams go from 5 people to 60 people. I've seen accounts go from 3 figures to 6 figures. I've seen a lot of cool things happen so far this quarter. May has really become May to remember. And I think when you're in momentum like that, it's sometimes hard to remember what it felt like to be brand new. And I find myself in this situation a lot. What was it like to be brand new? I can remember the emotion, right? I can remember some of the struggles, but I can't remember, you know, some of the things that I struggled with. Like, I can't remember some of the technical things. I can't remember, you know, what I needed when I first started, or what were the most important steps. And so we forget that new people are coming in every single day, and you only have one chance to launch someone properly. You know, when I joined this industry, YOLO became a whole new meaning to me. It wasn't the whole entire like dance or craze or whatever, you know, if kids nowadays would say TikTok something, right? You know, it was you only live once. Right? In this industry, it's you only launch once. You know, if I love traditional business still. I think brick and mortar are great. It has its fails to it, right? It has its negatives to it, just like anything else. But I like business in all forms. And, you know, when I hire employees, I'm not just going to sign them up and put them to work, right? If I owned a McDonald's, I wouldn't hire 16-year-old kids and say, good luck. There would be training involved. And it's the same exact thing when it comes to someone joining your business. Do you know the person that joined your business? Do you know why they joined your business? Do you know where they want to go within this business? Who they want to be within this business? Do you know the answers to these questions? Because when someone gets started, they're not starting because of the company. They're starting because of you, right? I just had someone on a call yesterday. One of her best friends is in this business. She lives in a completely different country in Europe than we do. But because of our call, she wants to join this organization. She's like, hey, honestly, like logistically, it would make sense. These teams, they're running events, they're doing meetups, but I feel something right about you guys, and I think you guys can get me where I need to go. So when you're speaking to the person that just got started, find out who they are and what their goals are. This is the number one thing, right? Just because you signed them up, guys, here's a little harshness to start the call off. You didn't impact them. Being honest, impact marketing isn't signing someone up. It's what you do once they're signed up. That's important to understand. It's the easy part is getting someone started. That's the easy part. The hard part is getting someone to exactly where they want to go. And that launch is not only for them, but it's for you. So many leaders ask these questions on Q&A. You know, how do I keep my team accountable? You didn't do it during the launch. You forgot to ask the question. How do I set the proper expectations with my team? You didn't do the launch. Now there's no expectations, right? So the launch is one of the most powerful things that someone's going to experience in their journey. If a plane doesn't launch, you think it's flying? You know what I'm saying? No, it has to launch. It has to set off. It goes its fastest during its launch period. And so what you do in someone's first 24 hours is not only what they're going to determine what they're going to do over the next 72, but it's going to determine if they sign up for month 2. That's how important the launch is. So what I'm telling you right now isn't to scare you. What I'm telling you right now is you have the tools and resources already there for you. You just have to learn how to use them. Because remember, it's never a lack of resources. It's a lack of resourcefulness. And that's the number one thing that we really have to focus on is the tools are there. The resources are there. The people are there. And a lot of what Jordan's going to go over today, you may not be comfortable doing. But you know what the best part about being in a people helping people culture is? You don't have to. Right? If you're brand new, get a P600, get a P1000, get a P2K to do your launches. I love doing launch calls. They're one of my favorite calls, to be honest, because it sets the tone for that person on moving forward. I love launch calls. Launch calls are my favorite. I get to build a relationship. I get to paint the vision. I get to, you know, see why they're doing it. It's refreshing. Launch calls are refreshing to me. I'm being honest, right? So find a way to enjoy the launch calls, because just because you signed 30 people up doesn't mean you're going to have 30 people next month. And if you signed 30 people up, if you did it properly, you should have 60 people the next month, 90 people the next month, if it's done properly. Now, there's three kinds of people, and we talked about it yesterday. We don't like to categorize, right? Because our main goal is just to educate and create level of understandings, and people will naturally push themselves into the flow. But what I really want to talk about today is the truth. 90% of people in my business, I think it's 91% now, it fluctuates between 90 to 92, you know, every month it's different. But let's just say 91%, 9 out of 10 people in QC are paying monthly customers. They don't have 2 in free. They're not P150, they're not P600. 9 out of 10 people are paying every single month. I heard Eric Worre say, "Who pays you?" I was at GoPro. "Who pays you?" Everyone's like, "My company. My compensation plan." In the back of my head, I'm like, no, you dumbasses. It's your customers. Your customers pay you, because guess what? The company ain't paying you if you don't have customers. Then you got a pyramid scheme. And then you really got an issue here, right? Your customers pay you, guys. 90% of your business are the ones that are getting you paid. But we're not excited about launching the customers because they're not building the business. But if the customers aren't there, we don't have a business. And so what I really want to talk about today, not myself, Jordan, because he's one of the best at doing this, you know, and that's something as a leader you have to understand, is there is leaders probably in your organization that are better than you at some things. And you need to let them shine and do that. Because Jordan is a monster when it comes to launching customers, retaining his customers, training his customers, and duplicating his customers. Not only just himself, but through his leaders, right? So we have to understand that our customers are getting paid, and we need to make sure that they're taken care of. We always talk about systems, right? We take pride in systems. But if the team doesn't know how to use the system, we don't have a system at all. We talk about having a blueprint, but if they don't know how to access the blueprint, we have no blueprint at all. We talk about 17 hours of education, but if they don't know what's in the 17 hours or what steps to follow first, they might as well go on YouTube and become the FTMO dude that's doing like 7% a month with 0.03 drawdown or 0.03 risk to reward, right? You might as well just go introduce them to him. At least he'll show them something, right? We have to launch our customers properly, right? So today we're not really going to talk about, you know, launching someone's business. You know, maybe Jordan will bring up a little bit about 2 and 3, because 2 and 3 to me is something that I think personally, when someone gets started with QC, the moment they go 2 and 3, they've seen the vision. They've seen what we're doing here. They understand the community. They understand the power of what we have. That's just my personal opinion. It's an opinion of a lot of other people as well. But really, Jordan's going to be talking about taking care of the customer and not just what day one looks like, guys, because I've done launch calls like this as well. And I've made this mistake too. I launched Ryan, but then I don't talk to Ryan for a month. And Ryan didn't do shit. And it's not Ryan's fault, partly his fault, but it's also mine. And I'm not saying Ryan doesn't do that. We all know Ryan grinds. We know that, right? But what I'm saying is, it's not just the launch. It's what comes after the launch. It's the homework assignments you're giving. It's the expectations that are being sent. It's the accountability. It's the call to action. It's the communication. It's all these different little things. And I had a great phone call with Brady today, so it's so funny. The brothers are taking this on, two of the best powerhouses here, right? I'm creating a document for you guys to check off as you're going through the launch, right? To check off as you're going through the launch. So, okay, did I ask them this? Did I ask them this? Did I ask them this? Not for the customer, but for you, right? So with that being said, guys, we all know Jordan. Jordan, the crypto savage, QC's newest Platinum 5000. He won't be he is the first, but he won't be the last, right? And he won't be at P5 for long. And it's because of the way that he launches people, right? It's because of the way that he takes care of his customers. It's because of the way that he helps people achieve their goals. It's because the way Jordan is, Jordan sees the results that he has. So with that being said, I'm going to mute myself. I'm going to step out the way of greatness. And if you're smart, you'd be taking notes. So Jordan, unmute yourself, my man. Take over. You're in complete control.
Jeez. Well, I'm QC. What is goody, everybody? Yo, like, every time that Tim, like, sets me up for a call, man, just feels so good, bro. You got me feeling a special way, man. I just want to shout the gratitude right back to you, Tim. If it weren't for Tim, I wouldn't be here, right? Some of you guys know my story. You know, I came into this as a trader. You know, I came into this. I wanted to learn how to trade. If you joined QCIM to learn how to trade, drop a 7 in the chat. And I'm pretty confident to say that is literally every single person on this call, because that's the culture that we built. That's the culture that Mike and Tim have built. So yeah, shout out you to Tim. Just so grateful for everything you've done for me. I mean, y'all know Tim. Tim is a savage, right? I really like most of the business skills that I have, I picked up from him. So man, I'm super grateful for you, Tim. Love you, bro. But yeah, guys, let's get into it. Who's excited? Who's ready? Who's ready? We got 47 people on the call. What up? How we doing? Vibe check. What's good? Yo, I'm feeling good. I hope you guys are. No one goes always to feel good. Love seeing these beautiful faces on the call. You know, leaders always got their cameras on. I hope you guys are taking notes, because straight up, like, if you're not taking notes, you're playing yourself. You're going to forget 90% of what I'm going to tell you in the next 45 minutes, unless you got a record of it. Take some notes, right? I still look back at notes. It's crazy. I still look back at notes that when I joined this company that I read. And they still are providing me nuggets. So, yeah, guys, let's dive into it. I mean, and Tim really kind of freshened my brain with, like, a bunch of topics to talk about. But first thing I want to talk about, guys, this is an impact call, right? This is an impact call. So this is about impacting people, right? And remember when I said, like, you guys joined this to learn how to trade, right? The people you're bringing into this business, into this company, are here to learn how to trade, right? And so I want you guys to understand this, because 90% of our business, and Tim, I think I have you beat, I'm like at 92% right now. 92% of my business is traders, people who are specifically here to trade, right? And so in this business model, right, you guys understand what we're doing here. We're in the business of a school, right? What is IM? It is a school that teaches people how to trade. You are in the business of bringing students to this school, right? And so in order for you to have a successful business, you're going to want your people to what? Attend school, to get the value, to learn what they came here to learn how to do, right? And what we're able to do, and why QC is so successful, is because we really get hands-on with our customers and helping them in their process of how to learn. I think one thing that I always say when people ask me on my team, like, yo, like, what should I do in the launch? Like, what should I help them with? Or what should I tell them? And one thing I say is like, well, what did you need when you started? What did you want when you started? What is it that when you started, you needed to have success? And I think with a lot of people, you come into trading, you come into IM, you come into Forex, crypto, all this, there is so much information that's out there. One thing I've noticed amongst new customers is that it's very, very easy for them to get overwhelmed, right? For them to think that they're not doing enough, for them to think that they're not going to get it, for them to, like, essentially get lost in the sauce, right? And so a launch, right? The most critical part of a launch, obviously, besides getting to know your person, besides getting to understand them, right? I think Tim covered that beautifully, but you need to give them a plan. You need to give them a plan of action. If you sign somebody up and you're like, all right, yep, here you go. You know, just go on IM.com or IM Center, you'll figure it out, right? That is not a plan. And your first day, guys, I want you to go back. For me, it was literally 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago now. I want you to go back to that day that you started. right? I want you to go back to Isaiah. Do you remember what it is that you did? Like, what did you, that you had your mentor, had you start doing? Did you even get launched? Right? Because like Tim said, this first 24 hours is the most crucial part of anyone's experience with this. You are setting the expectations and you are guiding them, right? You as their mentor, as their sponsor, have the ability to send them in whatever direction you want to send them. I want to send my people in the direction of success, right? And so what I'm going to pull up for you guys, remember how I said, literally, you got to give them a plan? We've already built the plan for you. We have it for you. It's one of the beautiful things about I Am About QC is that you have the ability to work with all these people that have done what you want to do. We have systems, we have tools. And like Sim said, it doesn't matter though if we have these systems and tools if everyone isn't using them. So the purpose of tonight's training, guys, I'm going to be breaking you down, walking through the launch document, what each thing means and why it's so important. And you're going to see after this call, hopefully, wow, like that launch document has been set up for me to really crush this. They've done that. We've done the heavy lifting for you. There's a plan of action that we've created. Your job as a mentor is to simply guide them. So I'm going to pull up my screen. I'm going to pull up the launch and we're going to go through it, guys. And I want to explain it in a little bit way, differently than how I would explain it to a customer, obviously, because this is an impact train. Let me pull it out here. So here we go. And I apologize if I'm a little laggy here. Holy cow, yes. This chat box went nuts. 1,300 messages. Yo, wow, love. Appreciate you guys. I can't pull up the chat. My computer is going to like freak out. But let's get into it, guys. All right, guys. So here's the launch. Right. The way I see a launch, and I like to keep the launch, you know, I want to keep this relatable, understandable, easy, right? And if you haven't seen this launch document yet, hit up your sponsor and be like, yo, you've been playing me. Because this launch document's been out for it's been out for a couple weeks now. This isn't something new. So if you haven't seen it, well, now you're ahead. I'm going to share this link in the chat after the call's over. But the way I look at the launch, the way I look at this document, the way I look at this business, like I said before, I am as a school, right? I am Mastery Academy. You get paid when you have students enroll in this school. But in subscription-based business, the number one most important thing is that your customer pays again. Right? They come back. They see the value and they want to pay for it. Because, for example, in this school, tuition is month to month. They're not signing a whole semester of tuition, right? So it is our job to continually provide them and guide them to understand how to go through this process of school. So think about this, guys. Think if you signed up for university, you went to a very prestigious university. I'm going to use my school that I went to, University of Illinois Chicago. I went there to study engineering. If I were to enroll in UIC and then they never talked to me again, how likely am I going back for a second semester? Right? That school is not going to make any money. So what do schools, and I think I love comparing this business to a school because every single one of us has gone to school. Right? In the United States of America, most of us have been through at least to high school, right? You've gone through some sort of education. And what do you get on the first day of class? When you're beginning a brand new class to learn a brand new subject, what do they give you? They give you a syllabus, right? And that syllabus will guide you. It gives you all the information you need, and it shows literally the process. You can look at a syllabus and understand, hey, my first week, I'm going to learn this, and then I'm going to learn this. And then I'm going to learn this. And these are my objectives with learning this. And that leads me into this. And leads me into this. So you can see the entire course of your education laid out in front of you. Why is that so important? Why is that critical, right? Again, we're in the business of a school, of bringing students to a school and giving them value, right? Why is that important to lay it out for them? Remember when I said what most customers feel when they join this? They feel overwhelmed. They feel lost. This is going to guide them. It's going to give them that clarity and reassurance that they're doing what they're supposed to be doing. It's going to give them a simple plan to guide and follow. like I said, the work has been done for you guys. You just have to understand how to show this to people, how to explain this to people, to explain to them the importance of it, right? Because we set this document up literally of 2 years plus experience for myself and all the people that have, all the, like, we collaborated on this document amongst a lot of leaders to create the best possible plan for a new trader to come into this knowing absolutely nothing, to setting them up to have future success, right? Because like Tim said, the launch, that first 30 days is the most critical part of anyone's experience in this, right? If you want a customer to renew, to keep on coming back, this is so critical. And in my philosophy of how subscription-based business works, like Tim said, if you don't launch people and you recruit 30 people next month, just being real with you, most of those people are probably going to leave and you're going to have to recruit another 30 just to maintain, right? And if you want to grow your business, now you're playing an endless game of always replacing the people that have left. So the approach that I've taken to this business since day one, because I came into this as a customer, I came into this as a trader, I came into this learning, wanting to learn how to trade. And I know the people that I sponsor and bring into this want that same thing. They don't want to be told to make a list their first day. They want to learn how to trade, right? And I believe, right, my philosophy is that if you build something, if you build a school, if you build a system, if you build a community that delivers value consistently day after day, week after week, month after month, it will build itself. If you build it, they will come. Do you think Harvard needs to recruit students? Do you think Harvard University needs to go out there and recruit students? No. Why? Because they've built a system that people have gone through and gotten success. And guess what? That speaks for itself. Because if I go through a program and I get success, I get value from it, guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to tell my friends. You don't have to tell me to tell my friends. I'm going to do it anyways because I've seen the value. Right? I really, really believe that about this, about us, about QC, about the way we do this. Because we take care of our customers. And that does the recruiting for itself. Because we know I have so much confidence in plugging people into this system and plugging people into this launch, knowing they're going to get value, knowing that they're going to have a plan. And if they don't follow the plan, if they don't see it, that's on them. I'm never worried that my people didn't get taken care of, right? Because we've duplicated this. Shout out to the Sniper Squad. They're very, very good at this, right? Shout out to all the people that have done this. Guys, this works. That's what I'm saying. This freaking works. Like Tim said, I have the results I have because of this, honestly, because of this. I literally can say because of my ability to be able to launch people, right? And so in the very first week, right? In the very first week, this syllabus is so set up for you guys, right? You know, and your responsibility when you bring and break this document down to somebody is really, the point of this is to show how easy it is. To show how easy and simple the process we have is. To give them that clarity, to give them that reassurance, so they don't feel overwhelmed, so they don't feel lost, so they feel like they actually have a course of action. Because guys, this is it. This is the plan. The value you have, the reason why people join you is because you know where you're going and you have a plan to get other people there. This is the plan, guys, right? And so it even says right in here, the very first step of this is to set up a launch call because you need to get on a call with them. You can't just sign them up and give them a syllabus, right? Figure it out. I mean, you can, but I really don't think, I mean, I like to think of this like, you know, if I want to fill a classroom every day, because it's literally my business to do so, if I'm not involved in explaining these people, how many people do you think are going to show up to class, right? So guys, let's get into this. Let's get into this document. What's in here? Why is it important? Why it's literally so dumb easy, right? So very first thing, here's a beautiful question about the launch. And really, this question right here should take up a majority of your launch with somebody, right? Like Tim said, you have a very, very small window of opportunity to take advantage of it when someone joins your business. Usually within 24 to 48 hours, you should be on a Zoom call with them, helping them set up, showing them, painting them the vision. If you wait any longer, the excitement's gone. They might not even care anymore. And then, you know, you wait till day three, they can't make it, turns to day four, turns to a week. Now you've wasted a whole week of their first launch and they haven't even got started with anything, right? So it's so critical to get this set off on the right foot because it's your one chance, right? And what you should be talking about is this question right here. And I will literally ask people this. Why are you here learning how to trade? Why did you sign up? Why? Let me make something clear. The launch call, right, is not you reading this document to them. People can read. Don't waste your time. Don't waste theirs. Don't read to them every single line. So, yeah, you know, when you start, you know, you're going to do download these apps, right? MetaTrader 4, and then, you know, click on this one, you know, and then in week 2, you know, you're going to do this. And then, you know, in week 3, you're going to do that. You're going to bore the shit out of them. They're not going to listen to anything you say. If your semester day one, if your professor day one, your teacher, whatever school you've been to, right? Relate back to your school experience that you had. If day one, your professor said, hey, you know, day one, we're doing this. Day two, we're doing this. Day three, we're doing this. Week one, we're doing this. Week two, we're doing this. Week three, we're doing this. And spent the whole first hour explaining to you what you're going to be doing 6 weeks from now. How much value do you think that has? Right? Because it's here. And what's beautiful about this document and what we're going to get into next, right, is the accountability that's included in here. The ability that you have to check in on your people to see if they're really doing what they're supposed to be doing. It's set up for you to be able to literally lead them through their first month. So let's get into this, right? Let's get into some of the details of this document that I think are important for you guys to understand when you are launching your people, right? Because these beginning things are easy, right? When you talked about why they're learning how to trade, when you understand their intentions and their motives, that is the most crucial part. And this first step can't be overlooked because that is what's going to help you to get them to success. If you don't know where they want to go, how are you going to get them there? Because guess what, guys? Not everyone wants to be chairman, right? And especially now, you get a freaking FTMO account and you're trading 100K account. Like, man, I love the business. I love residuals. But what the hell is chairman 10 when you're trading 100K account and you're pulling in like 5+ figure? You know what I'm saying? So it's really set up for people to have that success here, guys. The vision of trading is sound, right? And if you're like myself, you're here, you want to help people, that's lit too. So really, with week one, this whole first part is super, super self-explanatory, right? Let me check this chat and show me any questions. So bless. Appreciate y'all. Yeah, the new, I wanted to make this super, super easy and dumb simple to follow, right? Where anybody can come through this, look at it, right? And so let me minimize this chat here, my computer's slow. Sweet, okay, cool. So these first two steps, right? Super, super simple, right? You don't have to like read this to them. They'll figure it out. Okay, I have to download these apps, right? Begin learning, right? Explain to them. This is literally your only goal in the first week. 100 and 200 series. Start here, right? And then on a supplement to that, learn how to enter a trade idea from QC Trade Ideas into your demo. Guys, this is, remember what we're doing here, right? We're in the business of helping people in their trading education. How do you make money in trading? It's not a trick question. Taking trades. I'm gonna shit on myself right here, right now. Because, and maybe some of you guys can relate. I've had customers join my business and they don't even take a trade in their first month. Has that ever happened to any of you guys in your business? Where they're just in this learning phase, you know, I'm studying the academy, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. My chat box isn't loading, guys. Sorry if you're asking questions. Oh, no, it did. Cool. When the vision, right? The vision, Melanie, the vision's everything. Their vision, right? I ask their vision, what they want to do. And then I explain to them my vision, right? And it's kind of find that middle ground of the vision of where we want to go. Right? That vision is just to create that conversation, You know, it's a pain in the head, right? Because a lot of people, when they talk about vision, most average people that talk about vision with each other talk about it in almost way of like, haha, that's going to be so dope when we go, like, yo, wouldn't it be so lit if we were all like making six figures residually, trading six figure accounts and could travel all over the world whenever we want? And they talk about it in a way that's like, yeah, but that'll never happen, right? Because we live in the real world. But when you talk to someone who has vision, who has real vision, it doesn't have that tone. You're like, wait, this person's serious. Like, he's actually serious about this vision. Like, he's going to do it. So the vision part of this, like what to talk about, is literally just, yeah, you providing that sort of like confidence in the vision that you have for them, for this, for QC, right? I think these ones are self-explanatory. I didn't explain. There's a lot of information on this document, so I can't possibly explain everything to you guys right now. But yeah, you need to show them how to navigate IAM that time. Right, show them where the academy is, show them the basics, show them the QC tokens, right? So they know where to find the info. Just show them where it is. Really, that's just something so simple, right? But getting back to this, right? Getting back to begin learning, learning how to enter a trade idea in your QC ideas. If you guys are like me, and like I said, I can only speak from my own experience, right? I remember the first time I ever plugged in a trade on my phone, and I made like, I got lucky, I over leveraged. I made like $150. And that sold me from forever. It literally sold me on trading forever because I saw it in my phone and I understood it and I did it, right? So we don't want to have people just guessing, right? Putting in trades. But at the same time, if that's what it's got to be, so be it. But you need to get people. That is literally, and you're going to see every single week how we're going to evolve this of them taking trades. They need to be taking trades. Week one, they need to take a trade. They joined a trading company to learn how to trade. And they need to learn how to take a trade. Wow. Nugget, right? Shit, it's not like, you don't have to make that complicated, right? Teach them how to take a trade. Say, hey, right? You're going to go through these series. They're going to explain to you the terminology. And when you're done with that, you know, this is the trade chat. You're going to help them. So there's like, these are all the things that this is set up for here for them to know what they need to do. But this is also set up for us to know what they need to do to keep them accountable to it, right? And then there's personal development. So the next thing I want to explain is the action goals, right? They've gone through all of this. They've been through the 100, they've been through the 200. You know, they either figured out how to take a trade idea on their own and they were successful to do it, or you got on a quick 5-10 minute call, showed them how to plug in a signal, right? Now they're plugging in, they see the value, right? And so these action goals, these here are bonus goals. I set these up for, you know, someone who's coming into this, not just looking to be average, right? Because to get on average results, you have to put in on average work, right? And so some people, you know, they're coming in there like, I realized like some people will complete this whole thing in their first freaking day, right? And so I wanted to have goals to challenge people. And the way when you present this to people, you can literally be like, hey, if you're a real savage, you know, the real savage is the people who really go hard at this, you know, in their first week, they get on a call and they recap what learned. They create a vision board. They're already hopping on Go Lives. They're hopping on the Zooms. The real savages do that. So be fun with the guys. Give them a little friendly challenge. Right, tell them, hey, here's your goal, right? And so let's move on. Let's move to week two. And you're going to see how well this is set up. Because, guys, I put a lot of time into this, the setting it up and just the thinking, like, what is the most optimal way to bring someone into this business? And really, what would I want them to do in their first month to set them up for success, right? And here's where we start to get the links. And so this is also super dope. These are all hyperlinked. Right? You literally click on this link. What does it do? It brings up the trade course. Right, so this syllabus is designed to always be there for them. It's like their guide, it's their buddy, it's the map. This is the map that they have to guide them to profits. If you follow the map, you will get there, right? And when people understand how powerful this is and this duplicates, just watch this go crazy, right? We're already going crazy, right? And we all get in a line and we have that same launch process, yo. Right, and so continue your education. Week two, you should already be done with the 100, 200, right? You're having them literally get into the sniper course, right? A lot of people have no idea how to use TradingView. There's a few videos in the academies, but But Mike, if you guys were on that session a while back, he went in a full hour on how to use TradingView. Right? There's that. And then we have the 365, no, 9 to 5. Ooh, guys. Who loves the 365, no, 9 to 5? Give me some threes. Give me some threes. Yo, the blueprints and system and tools that we have, yo, like, guys, you're literally just a leverager. We built them for you. Mike's built it for you. IAM's built the education for you. We've built the syllabus for you. All you gotta do is use it, right? And so it's literally set up week after week, right? Week two, here you go. Now you're getting into the sauce. You're understanding the process. You're learning how to use TradingView. This document right here, the 365 to 9 to 5, the video that goes along with it, is probably the most powerful thing that we have as QC. That we brand ourselves 365 to 9 to 5, right? To paint that vision week two. Because week one, guys, they can't take that sauce. They got no idea what trading is, right? Week two, we get them the sauce. We show them the vision. We show them the plan. This is organized in a specific order for a reason, right? And then we have them getting into the leadership trainings, right? And I believe this link is hyperlinked to the announcement chat. I'm going to hyperlink it to the YouTube chat after, I'm going to start YouTube after this, so it should take them to all our trainings, right? The personal development, you guys, we understand how important personal development is this, right? And then again, to continue having them take demo trades, having them to start to participate in the QC Snaps chat, having them attending a Trade House Go live session. It's all here. All the info is here. It needs to be followed. Shout out to Cody Tarnowski. Y'all know Cody. He's a savage. You know why he's a savage? Because he freaking went through the launch and he crushed it. And it set his ass up. That's why how you go from zero, nothing, no trading experience. And in 6 months, yeah, I mean, y'all seen what Cody does, right? And there's countless others. When I start name dropping, I'm like, dude, I got so many names in my head, but I love all of you guys. Just know that, right? I love you all. There's so many savages. It would take me the rest of this call to list out all the savages. So yeah, week three, you're just continuing to go, right? You're having them continue. They're getting into the sniper course. They're getting into the goal labs, finding your favorite. Continue to develop your trading mind in these goals, guys. These goals, these are the goals right here. They're set up to like, oh yeah, we can have them do these goals. Guess what? This is the perfect way for you to hold them accountable. Week one, want to hold them accountable? Hey, did you hop on a goal, Miles Go Live? Now, did you create a vision board? Did you, and if you even want to hold them, like, because these are bonus, right? So if you want to hold them accountable, list, did you learn how to enter a trade on your phone? Because, guys, I want to make something clear here. As a business owner that is able to leverage $500 million trading platform, I think we're close. I'm pretty sure we're coming up on those numbers, right? Someone that can leverage a nine-figure trading education platform. If you're doing everything for them, if you're holding their hand, hey, did you get your pencils for class? Hey, did you do that? Like, guys, we want to create independence, right? But we want to be there to be a guide, right? We want to be there to offer moral support. We won't want to be telling, nagging them, hey, did you do your homework? Nobody wants that. Some people might. But like I said, I can only teach them a certain. I didn't want that. I don't need someone nagging me, making sure I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing. I want someone to guide me, to provide that support, to provide that vision, right? So this is designed for that. This is designed for you to give it to them so they have their own guide so they can be independent. And it's also designed for you to understand what they're going through, what they're doing, right? To have a same game plan of a page of what you guys should, what your creator should be doing. So you're both on the same page of what's happening, right? So it just continues week three, right? And it starts to get, as you start to see, there's less and less of watch these videos and more of here's a goal, an action goal, right? Less and less of learning, more and more of applying. Because one of the biggest nuggets I ever got it from John Guaman in a private Q&A with one of my teams. And I asked him, I said, John, what is the one thing that you wish you would have did earlier One thing you wish you would have done in the beginning, he said, just taking action. Because I think sometimes some of us spend so much time in the learning phase. I'm a victim of it myself, and especially in this. And then we never really apply it. And then you actually figure out that, yo, like what he said, the nugget he dropped, he said, 3 days of balls to the wall action trumps 3 months of learning. You want to sit here and learn how to trade theoretically for 3 months in our academies and our goal lives and never actually take a trade on your own? And then you actually start taking trades on your own. You're like, oh, wow, here's the next level. I literally spent 3 months at level one. Guys, we should be getting people to level two of taking trades within, like I said, their first week. Take a trade. Put something in MT4. That is your biggest goal of the launch, is to get someone in this. And the whole idea of this launch is to not only get them to put trades in, to take trades, because that's what we're doing, we're trading, right? If you're a basketball school, you're teaching people how to play basketball and they never go on the court and actually shoot a basketball, what good is your school, right? But what we're going for this is we're going to teach them how to trade on their own, right? And so these action goals now are beginning to, hey, send me a before and after markup, right? Send me a trade that you analyzed and send me the after. Hector Islas, I got that nugget for him, right? Like I said, we got so much collaboration in this document of so many beautiful things people have been doing that have been working, and put it all into one. Why does Hector do that? Because that gets his people to start taking responsibility, to start taking action, and to start developing that confidence in themselves that they can do this. So yeah, week three, they should be marking up charts. Right? Choose a trading session. Pick 1 to 3 pairs. Start to develop. Talk to your mentor. You should start doing these things, right? Picking 1 to 3 pairs, this is something I never did. I wish I would have did way back. Shout out to Zach Hogan, man. Right? Pick a pair. Commit to it, because that is going to build their decision. That's going to build their confidence in what they're doing. That's what this whole launch and syllabus is designed to do, to get them confident with the process of what's going on, because the hardest thing to do is to start. To get the ball rolling. But once that ball is rolling, it's rolling. And once you're taking trades, you're marking up your own charts, you've found your pairs, you found your sessions, you have your trading plan, you're freaking lit. You're like, I'm good, let's go. You're getting that shit down, you're rolling with it. Right, this is how you build traders, guys. This is how you build people to see the value of what they're into, right? And I also, shameless plug to the Trade House, right? We got like, hey, I'll talk about training sessions here in case you want, right? And then week four, completion of the basic training. The goals, right? This is the real sauce. Where do we want to get them in their first month? Well, ideally, they finish the Trade Hearts course. Ideally, they finish all the education, right? Right, and like I said, I'm a believer in combining action with learning. Like John said, John does it. Oh, he does. I love that one. John Cuevas, shout out to the boy, right? If you guys have ever seen him do this in person, it works a lot. I don't know how it's going to work on a Zoom. But he says, imagine like you're staying there with 1 foot, right? You have 2 feet. I'm going to do it with my fingers. But action, right? Oh, learning. Let's do learning, right? If you're learning, you're taking 1 foot to start with your left foot, right? And your right foot is action. If you only are learning, you're just stepping in a circle, right? You're only stepping with 1 foot and you're just stepping in a circle. Same thing applies if you're only taking action and not learning. You're going in a circle. So in order to successfully progress and to continue, you must combine action with learning. Take 1 foot forward and learn something new. Take your right foot forward and then apply it. Every single week that's set up here, it says literally learn this, apply here. Learn this, apply here. It's set up for you, yo. Because if you're not applying, you're not doing anything. Like I just said, 3 months of it, 3 days of action can trump 3 months of learning, right? So the end of week four, the end of month one, the idea is that they're done with their trading education, right? Or they're done with the basics. They set themselves up to now participate, to be in the goal labs, to be on bounce back, to start trading their own account, to start taking their own trades, right? That is the action goals of this, right? Start dropping your own markups. And again, every time, like this is, these action goals are so beautiful for us as like sponsors and people who build this, because we literally, this is like, you know, people ask and they want that guidance and mentorship. If they're not looking at, like, you literally can tell them, hey, like, you know, this is, here's a goal for you. right? You can challenge them, you can inspire them, right? And these goals aren't just for random shit. Hey, just do this, because why? Because just do it, because it's on the document. Now, these are literally set up, and I've asked countless and countless leaders, and they ask me, like, what are the things that you want someone to do? These are all the things that they said. All the leaders who are making $1,000, $2,000, $5,000, $10,000, $25,000, $50,000, $100,000 a month in this, that have built teams and systems of traders that go thousands deep, this is what they said of what they want people to do. So this is no joke. This is, there's so many brains and information that went into this, right? And then month two, guys, because if they've gone through month one and now you've given them the confidence so that they can mark up their own charts, you've gotten them through, they see the vision, they see the process, what's going on, and they see how they can learn something and apply it every single week. Yo, why wouldn't you continue? You're like, yo, this is lit. I'm learning how to trade. 30 days ago, I knew nothing about Forex. Now I'm marking up my own charts, and I'm freaking taking trades. That's the craziest thing about this. And I think I love hearing some people reflect on it. I think shout out to Jared Lawson with the boys, right? I remember him saying on one of our chats, he's like, dude, it's so nuts. Like, legit 60 days ago, I had no idea what any of this was. And now I'm like in here, I know what's going on. I'm freaking catching pips. So it's just about getting them involved, getting them plugged in, giving them that guidance, giving them the plan. This is the plan, guys. The point of me breaking this document down for you guys like that I did just now was for you to understand why it's so important and what the critical parts of it are. So you, when you show someone this, you can give them that vision and understanding, hey, because like, if I've done my job correctly right now, you're like, damn, this training document's lit. This is really the sauce. This is the plan. If I can duplicate it and show people this, my business will explode exponentially because I have a system and game plan that not only I can do, but that I can duplicate. Because guess what, guys? I have damn near 400 people in my organization. Do you think there's a possibility that I can launch every single customer in my business? Absolutely not. I only got 24 hours a day, right? And so the point of having a launch system is that people that I've enrolled, people that I've sponsored, people that I work with can do what I can do. And they can teach it, and they can duplicate. This is duplication right here. This is a game plan system. Month two, right? You've been through the process. Now we're going to apply, right? Follow your plan that you created. Week two, plug in, ask questions, journal. And then the beauty of it all, right? And you can see, I think this is powerful right here, these last two goals, is to show them what this process, where this process is going to take them. What the launch is going to do for them, right? You set the whole plan. You set the vision. You say, hey, here's your entire syllabus of your first month of learning. In month two, you're going to be getting in there and applying it. And our goal for you, right? And I'm going to modify this a little bit with just reason, like what we're doing with FTMO, is to show them like, hey, going through this process, by the end of the second month, you can make a small withdrawal from your account. Because how insane is that? Zero. And within 60 days, you've now made a small amount, even if it's $5, $10. I really, really recommend just having people make that withdrawal because you feel it's real. Withdraw $10. Buy a burrito. Forex funded. I'm eating a burrito that I made, that I paid for on my cell phone. If you can take someone from nothing to that in 60 days, you're going to have a really, really successful business. Guys, that's pretty much it. That's the sauce. That's the plan. That's the launch, right? Your goal here is simple. It's to show that plan. Help them with the plan. After how many weeks do you follow up to talk about their process to launch? Beautiful. That literally, you read my mind, Manny. Guys, that launch system is set there. If you want, you can follow them up with them every day. I don't suggest that. I don't suggest holding people's hands to that extent. But literally every week, you can follow up. Hey, how'd your first week go? I'm like, great, great. I got all this, and like, I did it, and I got the document done. Awesome, that's great, right? And some of those goals, you can say, hey, where's that first markup at? You marked something up? Did you take a demo trade, right? Did you TP? the planet's worth 100,000 burritos. So really, that's so funny. But really, this is set up where you can follow up with them as much as needed, right? And that's part of the launch. And that's the last part I want to talk about the launch, right? Is, do I walk through the entire document on a launch call? No. The only reason I walk through the entire launch document right now is for you guys to understand how it works. I do not walk through the document. I literally, and that's what I'm going to end this call on, because I thought that was important to understand you guys what that process is like for someone to show them, like, the ideal process for you to be able to guide people. But no, I do not read them the whole document, because they can read. And they're, like I said in the beginning, they're not ready for week two sauce and week one. You start talking about compound interest, this, that, they're like, bro, I don't even know what a PIB is. You know, so that launch call, that launch process, and like, I think sometimes we think, okay, I launched them, I got on a call with them, their first day, I launched them, and that's it, they're launched, they're done. No, the launch is continuous. You have to continue to launch them. It's not over in your first call, right? So yeah, follow up in week one. Hey, did you get those action goals done? How are everything goes? Are you struggling? What can we work on, right? Week two, week three, you now have a benchmark and a guide on that document of how fast they should be cresting, how far they should be going. And one thing I want to mention too is, like, that document is set up time-based, but time's not real, guys. If that launch document takes you 2 months to do, cool. Let them know that, right? You take that as fast as you want to go with it. If they're done with it in 3 weeks, even better, 2 weeks, cool. It's as fast as you want to go. It's as fast as you want to go. But really, you know, one of the most important things, what I want to end this on, is just, you need to know how to hold your people accountable. And that's what I end every single launch on, is that, how do you want to be held accountable? That phrase will really blow up your business. Because, and this is that conversation of, you know, how much do I follow up? Guess what? I'm not a person that needs to be, I don't want your ass texting me every day. That just annoys me, right? Check up on me every couple of weeks. I'm good, right? If I need something, I'll ask some people, but I understand that some people are like, yeah, man, like, you know, I would like to have that accountability on daily. That's me. So you need to know that for your people. You need to know how they need to be held accountable. And now you have something to hold them accountable with, right? It's really that easy. So know your people. Get to understand them. Show them the plan, right? And now you have the sauce. Now you understand how powerful the plan is. You understand what should be done, what the expectations are. You've set them for them. That plan sets it for them. That plan sets it up, right? And if you say, like me and Sammy, like, you know, I love systems because we love duplication and we want to expand this to millions and millions of people, you understand how powerful that launch document is, because it's not something that you can do. It's something you can teach somebody else how to do, and they can teach somebody how to do, and you duplicate. And that's how you build a big business. So, guys, appreciate you guys for being here. Mad love to you guys, QC. Yo, shout out to the family. Y'all inspire me so much. Just being in the chat, it's like, literally, it makes me smile every day. There's ranks being pumped like madness every single day. Honestly, there's so many flyers that come out every day. It's a beautiful thing to see. I'm just so freaking internally blessed to be here, right? You know, we got Hector dropping mad bars in 2 minutes, 3 minutes on the sharpshooter training, guys. You know, that's clearly going to almost be like a follow-up of this, because that guy is the duplication master of traders. He is the most five-figure traders on his team of anybody in the entire QC. There's a reason for it, right? So, you know, if you want to learn from one of the guys who's duplicated the most traders, he's going in at 2 minutes. I know I'm going to be there. So many nuggets. Guys, I appreciate you guys. I love you all. If you need anything, if you want some follow-up training, if you have some questions about this, you need some more guidance and watching people, let me know. Follow me up. Hit me up anytime. I'm here to help. I'm going to drop that launch document in the QC chat literally as soon as I close this Zoom. Or actually, I think Tim has to. But guys, I love you. That's it for me. Peace out. One love, fam. Have a good one.